Hello and welcome to the GR Supra GT Cup Asia 2020 Regional Round, brought to you by Toyota Gazoo Racing and powered by One Esports.
Okay, there's three to watch that we've picked out. There are 15 competitors coming your way, three races throughout the afternoon, but we're going to get going pretty quickly on the Fuji International Speedway. Let's go racing. The Fuji International Speedway. Tir Amohazik, you called these three and they are leading the way. Long way to go, admittedly. We're only on lap one of seven, but Ali from Taj Island, from Sirigaya. Taj tries to go down the inside. Ali closes the door.
Indeed, and the fact that he tried doing it last time. He just ran a bit too wide. He overcooked it coming to turn one. He's got a massive amount of speed here. He's got to go around the outside. Relive comes into the inside. Can he make the move down this time? He doesn't have the run of him. He has a run of it now. He goes around the outside. He have to avoid touching. Otherwise, both of them might spin. And Lalave closes the door firmly. Great defensive driving there from Tarras Lalave.
GR Supra GT Cup Asia Regional Round. Race one of three is won by Singapore's R. Mohammed Ali. And he has done it in style. 6 seconds clear. Second place will be Suji of Malaysia ahead of Taj Iman. Lalave holds off Shazli's Land 4, P4. Tokyo Expressway, East Outer Loop.
Go through the flyover. Does he come at it? Have it? Does he have the line? No, he doesn't. Sirigaya holds firm and he takes lead. Oh, he's light! He's into the barriers!
Wow, that's a mistake from Sirigaya. Is he able to hold on? Ali looks on the inside. Ali gets on the inside. And Ali takes the lead. Lalave, Raghav, Sirigaya goes from P1 to P4. All on the mistake because he misjudged the corner. Sirigaya still in P5. Further down, Padilla has got ahead of Jason Tay. Jason Tay retakes it from Padilla. Padilla retakes it from Jason Tay. That's down in P10. Wow, so many overtaking maneuvers on this first lap.
Oh, P2 to be exact. And I think I called it wrongly because that's where the penalty was, just right there. And he held on second.
There's an incident.
Whoa!
Hafiz has lost 2, 3, 4, 5 places. Mio Hafiz, catastrophic day, goes from bad to worse. He's elevated or demoted from P4 down to P14, down to P15. Mio, you have had one unlucky day today. Ali, though, has the lead from Lalave, and it's a 1.7 second lead.
He's already clear of the slipstream, and Sirigaya only now manages to get back up to second. Does he make the move stick? We can't see, no. Thunderpod breaks even later, but too deep. He goes hard, and he runs wide. Thunderpod's going to lose position on the way out of the last corner.
The Shazlizan can just hold it on. Thunderpod is trying to battle back. Oh. He was almost squeezed into the wall. Oh, the sparks flying once again. Thunderpod and Shazlizan, they are neck and neck, side by side. And in the meantime, I think Valtuji is just waiting for them to knock spots out of each other, and he will just capitalize in P9.
Will he make the move stick? He will try. He's up to seven right now. We're almost coming to the first corner. He makes it stick. Unbelievable maneuver. Suji got the double toe and he takes seven.
And then he slides. Iqbal Suji, is he able to hold on? The answer is, oh, he's under pressure from Thunderpod. Iqbal Suji, though, has got himself up into P7. Nurshad Lizan 8, Thunderpod in P9. What a terrific race between these guys. I can tell you, Ali is 3.5 seconds late. He's got the points. He's in the distance. Sirigaya still in P2. But Suji, there is Ali, comes through. Lalave 3, Iman will be in 4, Jason Tay in 5, and quite rightly we ought to look at this battle for B7, because once again Shazlizan is trying to squeeze through. Shazlizan and Suji and Thunderpod.
It's the Nürburgring Nordschleife.
Final corner before the carousel. If he gets onto the inside, he's going to be a brave man to do so, because he could go offline into barriers. He's touching him. He's touched him. And Lalave nearly loses it.
Tananchai Anan, who's right behind him as well. So three in a row. Penalties for Jason Tay as he looks on the inside. It is very scrappy. Good description.
And it's another one. And we come through U2 corner. Oh, he's hit him and he spun. Lalave spins into the barriers. And just as I said, Jamie Broadbent called that U2 corner, and you are into the barriers on the inside. And look at that 11 second penalty.
Sirigaya, 220, 230, 240, 250. Full speed as they go up towards the Adana Forest. As Iman leads a little bit ragged, just catching the camber there. Troy Iman, Taj Iman leads.
Oh no! Back. Oh my god! Sirigaya tried to go through Adana Forest, and he did! He shoves Taj Iman out of the way, and he takes the lead.
Raghav in P6. There he goes, just over the brow of the hill.
So the penalty. He's okay. There we go. So you guys have his penalty. Now it's 3 tenths, 2 tenths. between Taj Aiman. Oh, if only the camera was focusing on him right now. There he is. Taj Aiman takes the lead of the race. Siri Gaya drops to second. That penalty was enough to actually spoil the momentum. And Taj is back in the lead.
Taj Aiman in the lead. Siri Gaya drops to P2. What does that mean for Alif? At the moment, P3 is good enough for him. And Alif is closing up on Siri Gaya. But Aiman is really making a play. He'll pick up 18 points for the victory, assuming he can just hold on for these last couple of kilometers. Alif in P3 is the potential champion. Siri Gaya chases, tries to capitalize as they come through. Aiman takes it. Siri Gaya second. Alif will be the champion in third. Iqbal and Chazli's on 4 and 5.
Counting down from fifth position, we have Relive from Philippines, Suji from Malaysia in fourth, third position Siri Gaya from Thailand, in second Aiman from Malaysia, and by only 3 points, the champion of the GR Super GT Cup Asia 2020 is Alif from Singapore.